Next, we have my good friend from Japan, Dr. Shinji Sumimoto. He works for Fujitsu. He's a system software development, he works for the system software development division. He's the next generation technical computing developer at Fujitsu. He's in charge of technical development of the whole software system stack for the next exascale computing system. I'm intrigued by snapshots, so I'm looking forward to hearing this talk. So let's give it up for Dr. Sumimoto-san.
Thank you for introduction, Shimon. So this is the last talk, so let's wake up. So I talk about the title of DLSnap, Directory Level Snapshot for Facility on Rust. Okay. So here is my outline of talk. And first I talk about motivation, status, and goal and contribution plan. And then goes on the background and what is DLSnap, and use case and utility commands. And then we have finished the prototype of DLSnap and its implementation and evaluation. So first my talk is the motivation. I already talk about some kind of backup files. So everybody think about a backup file on a large scale file system on an issue to solve. However, existing system level backup requires a large storage space and backup time. So we started to develop a snapshot function. And current status, and maybe we started to develop a snapshot function, and we have developed a prototype the function. So why I presented here is the goal of the presentation is presented and our snapshot specification and the prototype implementation and discuss and its usability and gather user requirements. So if you are interested in my our function, so please give a comment and feedback and a presentation after my presentation. So it's a contribution plan. We plan to contribute mid-2017to Rust community. And so let's talk about background. As I told you, maybe it's difficult to make a backup of a larger file system, especially a petabyte file system backup takes a long time and requires its backup space. So it was maybe two kinds of options to reduce backup storage usage and backup time. A first option is using a snapshot to reduce replicate data. That's maybe an interpersonal talk about. And the second option is makes sense to whole of total file system backup. So section of backup area is a second option. So I talk about compare the two-level backup, and system level and user level. First, I talk about system level backup. We define a system level means a system guarantees its backup data and to restore the backup data. So in this case, usually maybe at least double size storage space or another backup device is required to guarantee data backup and restore. And in that case, maybe a backup time while service must be stopped during backup. In comparison to the system-level backup, user-level backup is maybe a user can select the backup data. Oh, this directory is very important, so I have to take maybe a backup. In that case, maybe some responsive is depends on the user, so file server does not need to stop. And we search some customer requirement. Our customer, continuing file system service must be required for our system operations. And that may be basically, such as a petabyte file system, it's difficult to guarantee the backup data to restore during system operation. However, some commitments or requirements is some kind of providing effective backup service with limited space, limited storage space. It's very important for our requirements. So we select user level backup, and we started to develop DL snap, which is a user and directory snapshot. So again, what is DL snap? DL snap is user and directory level file backups. And in this DL snap, user can create a snapshot of a directory using LFS command with snapshot and create option, like directory copy. And the user create multiple snapshots of the directory and merge manage the snapshot, including a merge of the snapshot. Now, this is maybe a user functionality. So DL snap also supports quota to limit storage usage of users. So user manages backups, include the quota limitation. And I'm talking about some use case, two use cases of DL snap. Firstly, maybe talk about it's avoiding file deletion or corruption by system operation. In this case, there are three snapshots, 3 days ago, and maybe 2 days ago, and yesterday's. Maybe take a shot. Maybe user can use a clone for every day. And in this case, maybe 3 days before, there are three files, file one, two, three. And just 2 days before, unfortunately, some file three has deleted. And last day, yesterday, maybe some file two modified. And today, oh, file three is deleted. In that case, maybe below the figure, user can extract new file three by using data copy. It's very easy. And this is a shadow in the directory, so user can easily copy, but read only. Second use case is maintaining large database with partially different data. In this case, some application gathering a daily incoming, a lot of data incoming, and make some large database for output. And a user can create a snapshot. In this case, December 1st and December 3rd and December 10th. And each case partially is maybe partially different data. So user can use the large database, but different data. So user can have some dips on December 1st and December 3rd, and also take some analysis for the difference. This is our use case. And I'm talk about a quote support and utility commands. A quote function is very important to limit a user's storage usage. However, a quota function is also provide manages. It's a very small. are a bit complicated because original data and maybe a snapshot data is different of its own users. For example, user A have a large database, 100 gigabyte, and another user are taking a snapshot on the user A, such as user B. And user B modified some 10 megabyte file. In that case, maybe a quota is recognized. Maybe a user A uses 100 gigabyte, and user B handles 10 megabyte. So maybe combination is very complicated, but quota DL snap also maintain and manage such kind of data. And it is difficult to see, but use the command, I think, explain. There are two commands, LFS snapshot and LCTL snapshot. And LFS snapshot is maybe a system level function which enabling a snapshot and getting snapshot. For the enabling snapshot, LCTL snapshot on FS name. And the command, maybe, but once we're getting a status of a snapshot, is a LCTL snapshot status and the FS name. And in the user side, creating a snapshot and the listing snapshot and deleting snapshot like this. So let's talk about the delete snap implementation. The implementation of the delete snap is copy on write base. It is implemented on top of the current raster LDISC FS and limited in OS level modification. So that's a modification is limited inside of the OS LDISC level. And also, it is without modification of EXT disk format. It's very important for Andreas said. So, and adding a special function to create snapshot to MDS also. And in the OS level implementation, more detail on the next page, and add function which create extra reference to OSTs, and add copy on write capability to the backend FS. And there are two methods to manage copy on write region blocks. There are two methods, block with my best and extend to region method. However, our file system based on EX4 based, so we selected the extend region method. So I'm going to talk about the basic mechanism of delete snap by extend region. For the left figure, for initial state, this is a file of number, data and foo and ABC. And original array icons on top of the file, and also mapped into the data block in the OSTs. And when are we taking a snapshot? That's another difference and the point block in the original file point two. So again, we are taking a snapshot, and it takes a region to a copy and region. And the data is also maybe some snapshot data is located on slab data and foo and dot match, such a match directory name and foo slash one. One is maybe a generation of a snapshot and ABC. In that case, maybe a same data block in the OSC is shared, however, set to read only. And another data is a new data coming on the slot data and the foo and ABC. So next, when I've been writing on the original file on top of the last operation, in that case, allocate a new block on the OST and write the data to the data block, and also creating a original file modification extent of the data block. So originally, there may be four blocks, and keep it to copy on write. I've added a new allocation block and wider and extend region. And maybe a new file is added in the next to the file block. So at this situation, it's overwriting the original file. And it allocates a new block on a new OST and copies the original data block. Then the point of the data block. So in that case, maybe a first block in the in the modification. In that case, it's a copy on write, and there's a newly allocated data and copy the data and the modification. It's very simple. So it's very brief. We have developed a prototype of a delete snap and evaluation its performance. In this figure, this was, we have some tests, file size 1K to 100 megabyte, and this is a copy time of 100 files. Maybe a CPU command and our make a snapshot function. In this case, maybe as we expected, it is difficult to see the 1 kilobyte file system, faculty data, and 1 kilobyte file is maybe 6 files, set longer than that of copy command. However, the time on the 100 megabytes is over 5 times faster. Next, write performance by IOR. Here, also have tested in the file in 1 megabyte and 100 megabyte, and maybe a YX in a megabyte per second. This is very simple and a single MDS and single OSTs. As you can see, there may be a compatible patch for once to regular file. Some of faster and maybe below, but it depends on some location of data on the OST, maybe AXE file, EXPO file system. So next talk about maybe read performance. Also, all the same. So compare performance to a regular read. So it's almost final presentation. So we contributed plan to the middle of 2017 to Rust community several months after shipping as a product. And this is a vendor neutrality is very, very good. And because of this implementation of the DLSNAP is absolutely vendor neutral because no special hardware required and based on a standard Rust code based implementations. So I talk about some Fujitsu's Rust Continuity Policy because we presented here maybe LAD 14, so maybe 2 years ago, and maybe our policy. So in the presentation slide, we talked about Fujitsu with contribution, contribute open, its development plan and feedback, its enhancement to the Rust community. And Fujitsu basic contribution policy is opening develop plan and contributing production level code. So that just means measure we make a prototype and then we have a product. And maybe we deliver the product to the users. Maybe in that case, some customers maybe some modification, some tuning. After some situation on the scene, we contribute to the maybe a production level code to the Rust community. It's a summary. We are now developing a DLS snapshot and evaluate its performance. And the performance list shows that creating snapshot time is much better than that of user copy commands at line list. So this our contribution to the DLS snapshot is planned in the mid-70s. It's my presentation. Thank you for your interest. Is there any comment?
Questions for Sumimoto-san? No?
No?
Thank you. Oh.
Thank you.
Yeah, it is very encouraging to see DL snapshot facility. Have you compared with ZFS snapshot and seen performance difference or anything like that?
Do you mean maybe a ZFS snapshot is comparative? Compare the performance?
Yes.
But maybe I don't know the ZFS library, but ZFS snapshot is a system, maybe a system level data snapshot, so maybe I'll compare
some. Not the user level.
Yeah. So in comparison to maybe our snapshot, it's almost same as maybe a LD, maybe a client level, maybe a LCTL, find from a home function, making a snapshot and maybe for each file. In that case, our snapshot function is no need to stop the system operation. And maybe it looks like a user backup, make some CPU directory copy. However, the CPU copy is tuned and optimized for take and snapshot, no requires data movement. That's defined, so maybe a system level backup. So also maybe a GFS level snapshot is a system level backup. However, in comparison to the GFS level snapshot, and we are, our snapshot is a user level. And this user can select the data to backup.
Makes sense. Thank you.
Is there any
question? I'm on it.
thank you. Does this kind of patch on LDiskFS on Lustre could be ported to X4? Because I think this kind of modification is touching the LDiskFS layer. And could this be ported back to the X4 to make no big patch on LDiskFS?
Do you mean some we need to add some EXT4 level changes or not?
Yes.
Oh, we don't change the EXT level format because some data from how the data is maybe a snapshot, but we implemented such kind of data to store that region is one of the EXT file. So such kind of management data is on a file on the EXT4 level. So there's no need to change the EXT4 level code. And added function is maybe we divide it some source code, maybe dsnap.c, and no patch in the original code. We use some add the function and call the EXT function. So there, in our in the prototype level code, there's no need to patch to the original file. We added the special file, and so we use such kind of EXT4 level function calls. So there's no need.
Okay.
Do you have some comment and use case?
Have you modified FSCK to handle this? Because it looks like you're going to have multiple inodes referencing the same blocks, and that might throw some things off there.
And do you mean some it some require some modifications to the FSCK and LFSCK? Is that right? What? FSCK. Ah, there's no need to FSCK because our data, maybe user data is almost stored as a user data. And management data is also stored in as a like maybe one inode. So there is no need to change the current FSCK code. And also maybe incompatible LFCK, there is a, as you can see the this, file, maybe each of the snapshot file maybe figured as a file on the raster. So there are so many, it takes so many inodes. So in the LFCK case, scanned with the data. However, maybe in the OS level, there are so duplicate data, but the checker function is not so. So there is no need to change the LFCK file. So if I am wrong, please explain me.
So I understand how it protects the user against accidentally deleting something, but how does it save space? Like if you're running out of, if you're approaching your quota, how does snapshotting, is it like, do you put it somewhere else? And then you can, how does that work?
So your question is about how the thread space is saved?
Does the snapshotting actually use, I think you said in the beginning that a user might be hitting their quota, so this would be a useful way to solve that.
Okay, user data is created, maybe make a snapshot and then modify the whole of data. In that case, it's no. So snapshot is effective, so it's a partial data modification, that's only. So however, maybe our snapshot take a consume a number of inodes, because maybe one directory take a snapshot, one snapshot, in that case, maybe same as a number of inodes are consumed. However, data block, it difference, the data block, maybe a user can handle. and user can handle within their allocated data space. So it is maybe a user turn in my our DL snap. So users can select, oh, this directory has no effect to the data snapshot. User should copy the data. That is more effective. However, this is some partial data. Thinking about the user, in that case, user can take snapshot. So user have option, take a copy and take a snapshot.
So it saves, it's less space consuming than an actual copy.
Yeah.
Okay, I got it.
Because taking a snapshot, but the whole of the data modified, this is the same as a copy, almost.
Thank you.
Yes, for the snapshots and quotas, would there be a way that a user could say how much snapshot space am I, what part of my quota is are my snapshots taking up, and would there be something that an administrator could then go and look and see and say, oh, this person has X amount of space in snapshot?
So maybe such kind of move, so we consider, in that case, maybe a quota function is used. Because number of inode, number of states. So if the data is handled by allocated user space. So is that the answer for your question?
Okay. Thank you, Sumimoto-san.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it. It's snapshotting. All right.